Welcome back to my channel and continue our discussion about string handling. So far I have covered many examples and concepts about string class. Now let's understand what is string buffer. String buffer represents a mutable sequence of characters. It is an alternative, or I can say a solution for the string class, because we already know string is immutable. If we want to change any of the stuff, it's not possible, right? Whereas string buffer supports mutability. Mutable means we can change the value. It might be append, delete, insert or reverse, any of the functions. Whatever we couldn't able to achieve in string class, we'll do it over using string buffer. Now let us see some coding part. It helps you to understand much better. Let's initiate a string. The method we are invoking here is two lowercase method. We got all lowercase letters. But let's see, when you try to invoke this one. But when you try to call the string value, observe here, it doesn't change the value. That is the concept of immutability. Now let's move on to string buffer. String buffer str equal to new string buffer and give some text, whatever you want. Now let's try to explore about methods of string buffer. Str dot append. Add some text. To learn Java programming, compile the code and see the output, where you can see the added text also. This is the functionality of mutability. Mutable means we can change the string value. You can also add the text, delete the text. Here I am taking delete method from 0 to 7. Here you need to remember one more important basic point. We mentioned 0 comma 7, right? While indexing, whatever you have taken on the left hand side, that is 0, is included. And right hand side, 7 is excluded. So it starts deletes from 0 until 6th letter. Now the text value is changed again here. See, the deleted text is not showing here. We can replace the text. We can also do reverse. I just want to replace the text from index starting from 1 to 3 with the hello. Save the code and run. 0, 1 is space here. 0 and 1 is W, 2 is E. These three letters is replaced with hello. You got it now how it works? These functionalities we cannot do over the string class. And let's see one more most frequent method, that is the reverse method. str.reverse. Here all the text is printing in a reverse order. You have to observe one more important point here. In string, the original, whatever is there, it's not going to change. Whatever you call methods and however you do the stuff, right? Because it is immutable. But here in string buffer, whenever you do some manipulations, the string value is going to change. Now it reverses not the original one, the recent string value. I hope I explained pretty clearly. If you still have doubt, Please go ahead and practice this particular example one more time. All your doubts will be solved for sure. Okay guys, thanks for watching my videos. Stay tuned and see you in my next video.